Showtime.
Market, common mark.
and doing a film about my nightmares as I'm dreaming them. In order for the movie to continue, it was dependent on me having more nightmares. Well, fortunately, I did.
I'm a little frightened by what Wes may have tapped into. I frankly felt that it was over when we did the final nightmare.
In a town where movies go over schedule and directors go over budget, something far more evil is out of control.
Suffered its own terror today as two of Hollywood's best-known special effects technicians were found dead.
Part of the theme of the movie is becoming like part of the making of the movie.
Can you come with me in my dreams?
I think that only happens in the movies.
What happens when the story dies, the evil is set free. Now that the films have ended, the genie's out of the bottle. That's what the nightmares are telling me, and that's what I'm writing.
This is still a script we're talking about, right, Wes?
You've decided to cross over out of films into our reality.
The only way to stop them is to make another movie.
Oh, my God.
The bad man's getting awful close.
You're gonna have to make a choice.
What kind of choice?
Whether or not you're willing to play Nancy one last time.
No!
Mommy!
Cut the effect!
Isn't there somebody who can stop him?
That person's you.
Why me?
But it was you that gave Nancy her strength.
Nancy.
Where's my son?
Hey everyone, welcome back to the Hatch Boys. My name is P. Rich, and today I'm going to be reviewing and discussing Wes Craven's New Nightmare. Alright, so New Nightmare is a 1994 American meta slasher film written and directed by Wes Craven, creator of 1984's A Nightmare on Elm Street. This film's a standalone film and is the seventh installment in the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise. It is not part of the same continuity as the previous films, instead portraying Freddy Krueger as a fictional movie villain who invades the real world and haunts the cast and crew involved in making of the film about him. In the film, Freddy is depicted as closer to what Craven originally intended, being much more menacing, scary looking, and less comical. So with an updated appearance of Freddy. I really do like this film. Freddy's scary again and menacing and sinister looking. Oh man, I love it. It's a lot better than the previous films, we guess, throughout the franchise. Like after two, man. Well, like three, it's not so bad. Like I like three, and Freddy's not the worst in that film. Like after three, I find it starts going downhill from there. But all right, so kick off the plot synopsis. Heather Lanencamp lives in Los Angeles, California, with her husband Chase and their young son Dylan, played by Miko Hughes. And you may know Miko Hughes through all sorts of early films in the 90s. He was a great childhood actor. He was in Pet Sematary. He played Gage. He was in Kindergarten Cop. He was in Mercury Rising with Bruce Willis. Yeah, he's been in all sorts of films, and I think he's a really good actor. And then with Cecil from the Horror Channel show, the Horror Show Channel, in the Dylan's New Nightmare film, Miko Hughes reprises his role. So it's awesome to see him back. So Nancy is recognized for her role as Nancy Thompson from the Nightmare on Elm Street film series before focusing her career on television. One night, she has a nightmare that her family is attacked on set by an animated Freddy Krueger claw glove. It was a prop, and it comes to life and kills two of the prop cast or crew people. And and that's in the upcoming Nightmare film that they're coming up with. And then these two workers are brutally killed on set. And then Heather, I keep calling her Nancy, but Heather, yeah, she's playing herself in this film. So Heather wakes up, and earthquake is happening, and then she happens to notice Chase, her husband's fingers, cut exactly the way it was in her dream. And so now she's kind of like become suspicious about it. She's like, what the fuck is happening? Like, yeah, she kind of dismisses it, but she's like, you could tell like she's thinking about it. Like, it happened in a dream, and then it happened exactly the same way in her dream, and now he has the same cuts. So Heather receives a call from an obsessed fan who quotes Freddy Krueger's nursery rhyme in a eerie Freddy-like voice. And then she has meetings with New Line Cinema, where she has pitched the idea to reprise her role as Nancy Thompson in a new Nightmare film, which Chase never told her about working on. And then she returns home and sees Dylan watching her original film. And Dylan has, he's severely traumatized. He's like having an episode where he screams at her, and phone calls keep happening, and Dylan's strange behavior caused her to call Chase, and he agrees to rush home and from his workplace at Palm Springs, as the two men from the opening dream did not go to work. And so, yeah, now Nancy's like, they never showed up to work. Like, oh man, fucking Freddy got him, just like in her dream. And so Chase falls asleep while driving, and he's slashed by Freddy's claw and dies. It's a pretty good scene. You don't see Freddy, not till like, I think it's like 40 minutes maybe, or even longer. This is a long movie. It's an hour and 12 minutes, so I thought it was a little longer, but anyways. It's not too bad. The CGI, you see like his seat kind of like moving. It's like in CGI though, and then you see the claw come up and like scratch his fucking crotch. But anyways, so, and then the glove comes up and fucking slices him up, and then he drives his truck right into oncoming traffic. sort of something we see in Elm Street 5. You know, it's been done, but I mean, I like it. So now, Nancy finds out about Chase's death, and she goes to the morgue to see his body, and she's revealed of his body. It's all slashed up like a Freddy's claw, and she pukes all over the floor. Oh, it's a great scene. I really like this. I thought it was great. So anyways, now his death seems to affect Dylan even further, which Heather is like really concerned about, and her longtime friend and former co-star John Saxton tries helping Heather Lanencamp out. He suggests that she seek medical attention for Dylan and herself after she has a nightmare at Chase's funeral in which Freddy tries to take Dylan away. Yeah, that's a great scene. Yeah, you do see Freddy in the scene very briefly, though, but he looks awesome, man. And Wes Craven made him look really well, I think. The practical and makeup effects for Freddy is awesome. Like, I like it. I still like the look of Freddy in the second film the best, but this one is really good too. It's fucking gnarly, man. I love it. So anyways, so Dylan's health continues to like deteriorate and become increasingly paranoid about going to sleep and fearing Freddy.
Sleep again, never sleep again, never sleep again.
Dylan,
never sleep again, never sleep again, never sleep again.
Yes,
I touched him.
Kruger. And he has this little stuffed dinosaur named Rex, and he says Rex is the only thing that will keep Freddy away from him. So he keeps Rex at the end of the bed by his feet, so Freddy doesn't come and get Dylan. It's pretty cool. I like that. So, even though Heather has never shown Dylan her films, she visits nightmare creator Wes Craven, who admits to having nightmares that the film captured and supernatural entity, which has now been freed after the film series ended with the release of Freddy's Dead, The Final Nightmare. Yeah, you see Wes Craven in this film, and you see Robert Englund and Robert Shea in this film. They're all in it. It's pretty cool. I like that. I like that concept. I find a lot of people say Wes Craven is like really horrible in this film, but I don't think so, man. Like he's just playing himself. Like, yeah, like, but the dialogue's not even that bad. What I find, I don't think it is. I really don't mind it. I like it. So anyways, yeah, while Heather's talking to Wes Craven about his new project, the nightmare film, he wants Heather to play Nancy one last time, and so if she agrees to it, then basically all this will go away if she kills Freddy, like if she goes along with this film. But yeah, it's Freddy's just like an entity that became Freddy because Wes Craven had these nightmares. I like that concept. It's a great concept. I like that. It's something different. And he took the movie, he took the whole franchise in a different direction, which I really like. I do like that. I thought it was pretty well done, I think. So following another earthquake, Heather takes a traumatized Dylan to the hospital where Dr. Heffern, she's a pretty good actress, but man, I don't like her in this movie, man. Fucking, like, I get it, yeah, where she's coming from in a way, but at the same time, it's like, oh, she's just one of those doctors you want to punch in the face. But, so suspecting, she suspects that, like, Heather is, like, on drugs or abuse, that she's abusing Dylan. And then she suggests he remain under observation. And Heather returns home for Dylan's stuffed dinosaur while his babysitter Julie tries unsuccessfully to keep the nurses from sedating and putting Dylan asleep. And but anyways, they end up jabbing him. And he starts falling asleep. And then Freddy appears and right behind Julie. And this is awesome, man. And so it's basically, basically the same kill we see in the first Nightmare on Elm Street film with Tina. Oh man, it's awesome. He's like dragging her up the wall and he's like, hey Dylan, ever play Skin the Cat? Oh man, it's awesome. I fucking love it.
Don't stop it, you're scaring me.
I got it.
Nurses are seeing this too. They're seeing her like getting dragged up the wall and just all these cuts appear and blood just going everywhere. It's fucking awesome, man. And so now now the nurses know that Heather's not crazy. I like that. I love that. After Freddy like kills Julie and Dylan's dream, Dylan starts sleepwalking. Dylan leaves the hospital of his own. Like, yeah, he's not aware, but he's just walking. And then while Heather chases him home across, like, this highway, Freddy's, like, taunting him. Like, this CGI is, it's outdated, but it's not the worst. It's not the worst thing, like, the Freddy cloud. Like, it's okay, like, I don't mind it. It doesn't bother me that much, but it is a little outdated, but still doesn't bother me that much. And then there's like millions of Freddy's coming towards them. I think that's great. And this scene builds up a lot of suspense because like they're on the highway and all these cars are just coming, like going to fucking smoke them, like almost hits the kid, almost hits Heather. It's great, man. I really love this. So, upon return home, Heather realizes that reality's starting to overlap with Freddy's make-believe realm. And with John Saxton as Nancy's father, Don Thompson, and her street, Elm Street, so she's like in the movie now. I like that. And the exterior of her house and her clothes have all transformed into Nancy. Yeah, it's great. And when Heather embraces Nancy's role, Freddy emerges completely into reality and abducts Dylan. It's great, man. I love when Freddy emerges. Like, so well done. The light and the color of it comes through the sheet or whatever. And he looks so fucking scary looking, man, I find in this one. It's just awesome, man. And Freddy's not trying to be funny or any of that, you know, type of crap. So, yeah, I really love it. And so now Freddy takes Dylan to his world. Heather finds a trail of Dylan's sleeping pills and follows him to a hellish construct of Freddy's boiler room. Freddy fights off Heather and chases Dylan into a furnace. This is a great scene too. I really do like it. Some of the CGI effects, like I said before, are a little outdated. I'll get to that, but it's overall pretty good in this scene. And this scene like builds a lot of suspense. I find it's great, man. And so Heather so Heather and Dylan and then end up together. They push Freddy into the furnace and light it, destroying both the monster and its reality. And this is where the CGI bothers me. When Freddy's burning, like his face turns into like a demon or like the devil face, and oh man, it just looks so bad. But anyways, I mean, they should have made better practical, like actual practical effects for that scene instead of CGI. But yeah, that's the only thing I don't like about this film.
Freddy's coming for you!
They should have made better practical, like actual practical effects for that scene instead of CGI. But yeah, that's the only thing I don't like about this film. So Dylan and Heather emerge from under his blankets, and Heather finds a copy of the recent events in a screenplay at the foot of the bed. Inside is written, "Thanks from Wes for defeating Freddy and playing Nancy one last time." So her victory helps imprison the entity of the film, Freddy's fictionist world once more. Dylan asks if it is a story, and Heather agrees before opening the script and reading it. Yeah, man, and that's how it ends. It's great, man. I really do like this movie. As a kid, yeah, I found this one more scary than the rest of them, besides 1, 2, and 3. I found this one, like, scary more than 4, 5, and 6. So yeah, I did like this one. When I was younger, I always kind of thought it was a little boring, but I don't now or anything, but I did back then. But yeah, I always found this one scary. So yeah, I really do enjoy this film. That was my first impression of this film. Yeah, I think I was like, I was young. It came out in 94, right? Yeah, so I think I might have been 10, I forget. But anyways, yeah, I remember liking it and I thought it was scary. And yeah, so the cast, it's a great cast. Like I mentioned before, like I like all the characters and basically they're just playing themselves in a way. Like Heather is playing her and Nancy at the same time, which I thought was pretty cool. More of herself, but like a little Nancy too, in a few scenes, which I like. I like that. Robert Englund, as Freddy Krueger himself and the entity. Like, yeah, Robert Englund was great, and yeah. Miko Hughes, like I said, he was great, childhood actor. John Saxton's always great. I love John Saxton. Tracy Middendorf, I don't know if I screwed up her last name. Middendorf, Middendorf, yeah, Tracy Middendorf, as Julia. Yeah, I thought she was fine. Yeah, I liked her. David Newsom as Chase, he was fine. Yeah, Fran Bennett, like I said, she played her role good. I just don't like her character in the film. Yeah. Yeah, Wes Craven, he was fine. Like, I find a lot of people have issues with his dialogue, but I mean, it's not that bad. Yeah, I find the yeah, there's basically like you get the whole cast from the Freddy films in this, a lot of them. Like you get Sam Rubin, you get Matt Winston, you get Tuesday Night, like Nick Corey that played Rod in the first film. Yeah, you get a lot of them, which is pretty cool to see. I like that. Yeah, so I think they all work well together. Yeah, character development was fine for me. Yeah, the technical elements in this film, I really enjoy them. Yeah, the sound was fine. It was great. The editing was fine. The lighting's good. I do like the lighting. The colors they use in this film, pretty decent. Yeah, I don't mind them. The music, yeah, it's nothing really too special, but I like it. I don't mind it. Yeah. I mean, my favorite part in this movie. Man, there's quite a few of them I do like. I like how it starts. I like the opening when Heather has her dream and the Freddy Claw comes alive and kills those two prop people. I like that. I like that scene, yeah. I like when the babysitter dies from Freddy. It was great. Yeah, even Freddy's claw in this film looks great. I love it too, man. It's different. I like it. The ending was alright, just except for that CGI Freddy when he's dying, when he's burning. Yeah, I just don't like that. The tongue thing with the snakes, and that was cool. I like that. I thought that scene was really good, like really well done, I think. I thought it was cool. And I really enjoyed this concept of how Wes Craven taken this direction of this film. I thought it was great. It's something he always wanted to do too. Back in Nightmare 3, he wanted to do this concept, but different in different ways. But the studio turned him down for it. Yeah. But eventually he did get to do it, which I like. Yeah, all right, so. So, the television show appearance was inspired by a real encounter, according to Wes Craven, Robert Englund. Did an appearance together on public television in San Francisco area. It was about whether this kind of movie was bad for children or not. And there were parents in the audience, and then all the kids leaped to their feet and started chanting, "Freddy, Freddy, Freddy." I remember looking at the show host and the parents, and they all looked horrified. So I think that's according to Wes Craven saying that. Yeah, that's cool. So the events in the film revolve around Heather Lanencamp having a stalker in real life. She did have a stalker, and Wes Craven got her permission to weave it into the story. It's pretty cool. So director Wes Craven had intended to ask Johnny Depp to make an appearance as himself in the funeral scene. Craven never worked up the courage to ask him, but after the film's release, they ran into each other. Craven asked Depp if he would have made an appearance in the movie. Depp said that he would have, and that Craven should have asked him. So yeah, in reality, Heather Lanencamp's real husband is David Leroy Anderson, is a special effects man, and as he is in the film. All right, so the overall success of this film, the budget was $8 million, and box office, didn't do well, man. $19.8 million. Like, wow. I figured it would have did a lot better than that. I guess people were kind of getting tired of Freddy in 94, I guess. Well, like, the sixth one probably fucking ruined it for everybody, too. In a way, after 5 and 6, I bet people were, like, pissed off about it. Like, Freddy fans. Probably. Anyways, I recommend this movie. Hell yeah, I do, man. I love it. Like I said, like the story structure is great. The settings in this film are great. I really do enjoy the settings in this film. Even especially the end of the film when they go into that entity's world there, like Freddy's world, if you want to call it like that. I thought it was great. It looked awesome, man. Like that whole set piece, I loved it, man. And then the hospital scene, like, it's a hospital, but it was still all right. And then you're like in Heather's house. Not too bad. I didn't mind the scenes in Heather's house. What else? Yeah, it's just like, Yeah, some of the kills were fine. I liked it. I do recommend this film, and I give this film an 8. I give this movie an 8. Alright, so that's my review for Wes Craven's New Nightmare. Thanks for watching, everybody. Alright, bye.